The Alamance County Cooperative Extension Service presents Safe Turkey Preparation.
Hi, I'm Evelyn Deloach, Family and Consumer Sciences Agent with the North Carolina Cooperative Extension Service at the Alamance County Center. And as you know, Thanksgiving is going to be coming in the next week, and so we're going to be getting a lot of phone calls about turkeys and how to cook them. But the first thing that I want to start out with is to just say to people that one of the things you may want to not just consider, but that's really important when it comes to preparing any dinner, whether it's your Thanksgiving dinner or not, you need to make sure that hand cleanliness is utmost important. You need to wash your hands before, after, doing, whatever the case may be, because foodborne illnesses are a factor when it comes to cooking, and also in terms of making sure that you want to make sure that the people that you're serving are going to have a good, safe experience in your home.
Turkeys can be bought anywhere from 4 pounds to 24 pounds in weight. You can buy them fresh, you can buy them frozen, as well as you can buy whole or turkey breast. So it's a matter of preference and, of course, the number of people that you plan on serving as to what size you may want to buy. One of the things that I do encourage people is to realize that turkeys are very heavy. So when you're trying to put them, the turkey, into the pot, into the oven, it may require a lot more strength than you usually think that it would. And so just be very careful in terms of that to make sure that you don't end up dropping them.
Ow!
Because one of these turkeys dropped on the foot can cause serious injury. I get calls about how a turkey should be properly thawed. And there are three acceptable methods, and each one of them has their advantages and disadvantages. The first one I'm going to talk about is going to be this, in the water. One of the precautions that you have to be aware of is that depending upon your turkey size will determine how long it's going to take. It will also require that what you have to do is you have to change the water periodically. You cannot just put it in the water and leave it there for thawing. So you're going to have to be able to be around to be able to change the water. The second way to unthaw a turkey is in the refrigerator. And when we're talking about in the refrigerator, again, it's going to depend on the size as to the number of days that it's going to take you your turkey to thaw. So that means you can't go out on Wednesday afternoon and get a 20-pound turkey and expect that is going to be thawed out in time for you to cook and have dinner the next day. So we're looking at anywhere from 3 to 4 days for you thawing it in the refrigerator. You do not need to, whether it's in the refrigerator or you're going to thawing it in water, to take it out of the wrapper. You need to leave it in the wrapper, put it in the refrigerator on a tray, and then just put it also in the water with the wrapper on. The third method of thawing is the microwave. Again, a precaution in terms of the microwave is to be aware you need to have your book available and you need to follow the manufacturer's directions. When that turkey is thawed, it has to be put in the oven for cooking immediately, or if you're going to fry it immediately. You cannot just thaw it in the microwave and then put it in the refrigerator to be cooked the next day or later that day. It needs to be done right away. It's recommended that you cook your turkey at 325 degrees. And you need to be sure to follow the instructions also that are listed on your turkey bag. At 325, it is a good range for the turkey to cook. And we encourage that you use a thermometer also to gauge whether or not your turkey is 165 degrees internally. We also encourage people that if they're going to do a stuffed turkey, that the stuffing also has to be 165 degrees. Of course, it would be preferable that they not stuff the turkey, but we know a lot of people do that. The thermometer will keep some of the guesswork out of whether or not your turkey's done and checking to see whether the juices are running clear, those kinds of things. And so if you don't have one, I encourage you to go out and buy you one so that you'll have one on hand. The other thing in terms of thermometer and the proper temperature, we also recognize that there are some people that may be feeding elderly, pregnant women, people with compromised immune system. And so it's going to be very important that they make sure that that turkey is cooked to the proper temperature. After the turkey is cooked, you need to make sure that, or allow the turkey to rest before cutting. And that gives it also an opportunity to reach the internal temperature that you may need of 165 degrees. Some people, instead of roasting their turkeys, prefer to fry their turkeys. One of the things that we want you to be sure is that your turkey is completely thawed, that you do pat it dry. You're going to put the turkey in, you're going to put the water in, you're going to take the turkey out to see how far the water comes up, and that's your mark for how much oil you're going to need. Otherwise, you could put too much oil in your pot, cause an overflow, which may then cause a fire. So just be very cautious in terms of making sure that the turkey is thoroughly dry and also that you don't have too much oil in your pot. If you're like me, sometimes you forget a lot of the details in terms of exactly what the proper procedures may be, and you need a little reference. We recently did an article that you may want to get access to. That article is designed to be cut out so that you can put it on the refrigerator. It talks about the cooking times and the thawing times, and it'll be a good reference for you to have not only this year but next year also. If you have any questions about it, please feel free to call our office at 570-6740 and ask to speak with me. And if I'm not in, leave a message and we will give you a call back. I'm Evelyn DeLoach with the North Carolina Cooperative Extension Service, Alamance County Center.